Uganda Television hit the airwaves and did broadcast the event live. At the time, it was still in black and white. Haj Idris Mayanja Njuchi, the head of the presidential press unit during Idi Amin's presidency, reveals that the idea of upgrading the TV to color emanated from the 1975 meeting between Amin and former heavyweight boxer the late Muhammad Ali in Chicago, United States.
They had a conversation here and there and talking about life. Because he was a boxer, he invited Muhammad Ali to come to Uganda. Incidentally, Muhammad Ali told him he could not make it to Uganda because he had already scheduled himself to go to Zaire for a boxing match with the context. So during their discussions, Muhammad Ali told him he would be holding that match, and Idi Amin told him, okay, I will attend in person. And he, of course, directed, said, now we must cover this. We must cover this fight. And my people back home must enjoy the fight. After all, I'll be there, Field Marshal, and I was a boxer. It must be in color. We told him it is not possible because Uganda has black and white. There is nothing that cannot be done. He said, we must have it in color. You go and work out whatever you want to make it, we shall do it. So from that day, arrangements were made with the technicians, of course. I conveyed the message.
It could have taken ages to finish the procurement processes, transporting color equipment from Germany and finding a location for installation. However, President Amin gave out his presidential plane to the engineers until the upgrade was completed.
I remember Njuki, there is a lady called Engineer Njuki. She was in UTV. Even Agure Awori, this who one time wanted to be contested the presidential, yes. That one was also involved. Malik Farouk, I told you. Malik Farouk was the main. And of course, as a government, I think he took it on government level. From personal to government level. Because whatever he was doing, most times involved the government. So he directed, then the ministry took over the directive, and everything was the ministry's baby, actually.
The liberalization also saw social media and other internet communication service providers have a soft landing for business in Uganda. Some veterans are worried, while others cherish this technology.
Do you believe every trash you read on social media is correct? No, I've seen some stories on social media. A cabinet, I don't know whether you've seen it, by Bobby Wine Kyagulanyi, the speaker. You know, that lineup is there. So do you expect a man of my caliber to believe that story? But we read. The problem we have is our rate of literacy. Our rate of censoring ourselves is not there. Yes.
If you're asking me, I would. Because if you don't, you're also frustrating people. And once you separate somebody, he gets another way of getting the information through.
You see, these social media platforms think everybody is a reporter. That's the mistake they make. But this is a professional, professional job. You cannot just imagine somebody has a camera because he's got a smartphone. He takes a photograph and he thinks he's actually a journalist. So people want to be what they are not. And journalists are not like that. You may not find a journalist
actually covering or doing things like these media people do?
Well, the technology which is being churned out now is still run by human beings. Without the person behind that new equipment or whatever you're using, you won't get what you want. So it's you who controls the technology. It's not the technology controlling you. It's how you use it. If you're using it in a friendly way or in a way that will protect you, it will protect you. But if you want to also go in and say, I want to get a sound bite of someone who is being beaten, well, go in.
Kanyomozi say liberalization was done but should instead ensure freedoms of expression and speech.
The people who want to use them. I know what is going on in the world now. Those in power don't want information to reach everybody.
I assume this social media was in place at the time when you were still in government. Would you have tolerated such?
Of course. If you're asking me, I would. Because if you don't, you're also frustrating people.
And it was still government.
Yes.
Sponsored media.
Yes.
What is your opinion on the liberalization and the privatization of the media?
I am happy with it, really. I think I am a modern journalist, although I'm on the past, I'm from the past, but I am happy indeed, because there is freedom of that, and if they had left it like that, one would be very happy. That is why I am against anybody who chases journalists from here and there.
The veterans also feels uncomfortable in what they called brutality against newsmen.
It is actually the security forces that are to blame. Why? Because they want to direct. They want to direct
how the media should conduct its business.
They are not professional. They don't know anything about it. And I'm telling you, journalism is one of the best professionals for one reason, that it does things in the open and, given freedom.
At that time, the brutality against journalists was not like the brutality we see today. You find journalists are being beaten in the field. They're being beaten in the field because sometimes, even the person who is beating you could be a person who is maybe annoyed with you. Maybe he tried to become one of you and he could not become one of you. And so you see, there's certain things, there are different things that go through people's minds. And the journalist himself, like I say, should not put himself in harm's way. Try to get out of that fracas as much as possible. Although you're covering it, this camera that you're using has got a zoom lens.
No, during our days, there's no way you would be brutally handled. You're either killed or you disappear.
So brutality is a bit better than...
That's not a right word, because my colleagues in the media fraternity won't like my comment. But the English have a saying, to attack a lion in its den, what do you expect? You know this is a lion. You are trying to enter the den of a lion. So we need to be cautious.
Whereas Article 29.1a guarantees the freedom of speech and expression, which shall include freedom of the press and other media, the state has an obligation to regulate such freedoms not to tantamount to a threat to the security of the country. The question of the law and practice are still debatable, especially when the media and state collide. Has the information flow been changing for the worse or for better? Mubarak Mugabo, Aban Television.